upset the folks at MSNBC. I do want to mention a few things. Quite frankly, we need to depend on the internet. There is a system in the House where bills are supposed to be posted. It's called Thomas. You can look it up, U.S. House Representative. You should be able to read bills as they're going through committees. Check the committee's sites on that. But you also need to look towards your watchdog organizations. We at FreedomWorks try to keep you well informed. We've got two things that are mentioned here. The idea that we could sue the government on TARP and test its constitutionality, I think is a critically important idea. And you can read about that on our website, and that will help you link other sources. There is also, we talked to a gentleman here, said he was strong and able, self-sufficient, and perfectly willing and capable to take care of his own health care needs, even though he's 65. There are a small group of people that are trying, can you believe this, to just sue the government for the right to say no to Medicare. And so you can read about that, medicarelawsuit.org. But to find the bills as they're coming is really the tough thing. If the Congress, under this leadership, isn't forthcoming in posting the legislation, then I think you have to make a direct contact to your Congress, your own congressman, and ask about bill numbers and so forth, legislation results. You have to dig for it because they're trying to hide it, is what it amounts to.
Over here. How you doing? I'm Rick from South Carolina. I have a quick question. Why can't you audit the Fed? Who's running this place? You know, who's in charge?
Who's running Washington?
Yeah, Washington. We can't audit the Fed. How come?
I think they're missing in action.
That's a crappy answer.
Question over here.
Very quickly, I think it's Sam Johnson has a bill to audit the Fed. Get in touch with Sam's office. See what you can do to support that. Get the information. Share it with your own congressman. Ask him in turn to support the effort. But the fact is, again, I'm going to remind you of my observation. Three groups of people alive in the world that have the right to spend other people's money. Thieves, children, and congressmen. They need adult supervision.
Yeah.
You have it provided.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Christy from beautiful Estes Park, Colorado. Speaking of our God-inspired Constitution and our most important First Amendment right, I'd like to know if my Rush and my Mark Levin and Sean Hannity and all my our talk show radio hosts are going to be allowed to stay on the air. This awful FCC person that he has in, the one that admires Hugo Chavez and wants America to be like Argentina, I'd like to know if they can just ram that through overnight, or how is this going to work, and what can we do to protect our talk radio? Thank you.
On our toes here because they have figured out that you have figured out the pair to stop. And they're going to take another avenue. I'm not quite sure I understand it exactly what it is now, but community regulation or community responsiveness. And I think this might involve another czar. We don't know for sure who he will be. Oh, they already have him? I just bet you, Nickel, that his expertise in communications derives from painting the signs in red in the 60s. I'm just guessing.
Yeah!
Okay, last question.
Okay, yeah, my name is Darren. I see. And it's more of a statement than a question. Like, if you want to find out where the money's going from CAP and everything else, go to the